has a gun. That boy has a firearm!
He's cutting us down.
Gonna put you down, son.
Get him.
He's cutting us down.
Everything about Beva's business.
All the cash you bring in from selling hooch? I know where it's being stashed.
Yeah, now I call the shots.
Gonna enjoy this, boy.
Thank you. hell's happening there?
The reason I'm walking this route is because my car's in the shop.
What did those rednecks think would happen? Where's
need some wheels. And Burke says you're the only person we're talking to about it.
Well, Burke's a fucking genius in that regard. I'll head on out to you now.
One car is promised.
That's a big help.
Greetings and salutations, and all that shite.
You bear? Nikki sent me.
Oh, I'm gonna marry that girl someday. Bear Donnelly. I own Nikki's da. Everything. He has me keeping an eye on the Robert O. meatpacking plant.
Who's running things over there?
Nutjob by the name of Sonny Blue. Lets a room out to the butcher's loan sharks. Protection guys, too. If they can't do it there, they put the hurt to people in the street.
Any chance Sonny's around the Robert O.?
Fuck no. Sonny only comes around to scare his people into shape. But I'm hearing one of his boys, a fella named Ralph, got caught skimming. They're working the bloody bastard over in the slaughterhouse to find out where he's got it stashed. Might be beneficial to pull his arse out of the fire.
I'll see what I can get out of Sonny's goons. Watch your ass, Bear.
Sonny Blue's people are scared of him. Might not talk. Why not make him more? Heard you was friends with Danny, too. Goddamn fucked what Marcano did to him. The thing about Sonny is he's partial to knives. Fucker likes cutting on people.
You're the definition of uncivilized.
Hey, watch it!
Good. Thank you.
Trouble. Must have got his ass out of here.
Why do they have to be such dicks?
Start moving around.
Welcome to me.
We've got a fit. You're just letting...
Still can't believe Danny's gone. He was a good boy. Never appreciated how good until now.
Need something? I'm hearing it's been kind of hard to get some of the Sweetwater's moonshine in town. Good work. When this bullshit with my old man's through, you and me should talk. Looking pretty spry for a man who took a bullet to the head. When he boxed, they used to call him Brooklyn Bevers, on account that he'd hit some poor fuckers so hard they'd feel it all the way in Brooklyn. Word of advice, be careful mentioning the butcher around my old man.
come tussle with a motherfucker your own size.
What is going on?
Call me a hero for killing you.
Gun.
What's the crack with Irish Point and... Don't remember our deal involving taking for goddamn ever to execute Sal.
There's bravery and revolution in there. It's the foundation of our very country. Throwing off the yoke of tyrants, shedding blood for one's very freedom. It's a beautiful thing, dear listener. And if you got the courage of your convictions, if you're willing to sweat and bleed for them,
I need resupply in Point Madon.
Going at you. Hang tight.
You spot anything?
Let
you
me
can
see
use.
What you got.
This would... Good. Call me if you need
help. Go, go!
Going to Chud's funeral?
Too many fucking funerals lately.
Fucking Vito, man. Didn't think he had it in him.
Taking out Bull and his whole goddamn crew. Chubbs was loyal as hell. Loved working for Bull.
Didn't he just get married?
Yeah, he married that little redhead used to work the desk at the Dock Union.
Helen?
Helen, yeah. I guess he knocked her up some.
Jesus. To Chubbs?
Thank you.
How's it going?
You.
Don't let nothing happen to me.
Huh?
Wait.
Help! Help!
Goddamn gladly.
Run for cover.
Bevis can't be happy about what you've been doing. You got Carl's attention. He's back at the Sweetwater Distillery.
Any idea how he'll react when I go in there?
He's bug shit crazy swamp people. How do you think he'll react? Still, might be worth keeping him around. No one knows the bayou like he does.
Owe you one for this, Nikki.
Damn right you do. Bevis is waiting for you. Real interested to see how you handle him. All right, you've got the map. Now get out there and find those stills. Looking pretty spry for a man who took a bullet to the head. Bevis Moonshine hasn't been the same since the butcher came in and fucked the business sideways. When this bullshit with my old man's through, you and me should talk.
I need resupply. Send someone to Point Verdun to pick up my cash.
Hold your horses, I'll get to you.
Send someone to Point Verdun to pick up my cash.
Sure thing, Cher. Heading your way now.
All right.
Better not lose.
What are we handling today?
Going straight to the bank.
Waits.
some crossfire in Point Verdun.
You got it. We'll be around shortly.
It's all him. Let's go.
Is going out. What about you?
Oh, God damn it! All right. I'm in.
Irish will be in touch. Emptied out the distillery. It's primed and ready for your boys.
Thomas Burke came to the States as a boy when his father fled Ireland, likely because of his involvement in the Irish Civil War. After his father died of a heart attack, Burke started running booze to support himself. I mean, he turned bootlegging into an entire industry, and Sal Marcano took notice. Burke worked his way up the ranks, but could never be made because he wasn't Italian.
Murray's from around here. I always liked those Irish redheads.
I need resupply in Point Badon.
Yeah, be out directly.
Whiskey everywhere. Not a drop to drink.
You spot anything you can shoot at, Dundee?
I'm out of here.